Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Welcome to Lincoln Cathedral on this day, which is the final day of the church year, the culmination of our walk with the drama of salvation throughout the last liturgical year. And today we celebrate Christ the King, Christ in glory, at the end of what is the kingdom season. So let us pray. Jesus says, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. So let us turn away from sin and turn to Christ, confessing our sins in penitence and faith. The kingdom is yours, but we turn away from your just rule. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The power is yours, but we trust in our own power and strength. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
The glory is yours, but we fall short of the glory of God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who in Jesus Christ has given us a kingdom that cannot be destroyed, forgive you your sins, open your eyes to God's truth, strengthen you to do God's will, give you the joy of his kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Eternal Father, whose Son, Jesus Christ, ascended to the throne of heaven, that he might rule over all things as Lord and King, keep the Church in the unity of the Spirit and in the bond of peace, and bring the whole created order to worship at his feet, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
First reading is taken from the book of the prophet Ezekiel, chapter 34, beginning at the 11th verse. For thus says the Lord God, I myself will search for my sheep and will seek them out. As shepherds seek out their flocks when they are among their scattered sheep, so I will seek out my sheep. I will rescue them from all the places to which they have been scattered on a day of clouds and thick darkness. I will bring them out from the peoples and gather them from the countries, and will bring them into their own land. And I will feed them on the mountains of Israel by the watercourses and in all the inhabited parts of the land. I will feed them with good pasture, and the mountain heights of Israel shall be their pasture. There they shall lie down in good grazing land, and they shall feed on rich pasture on the mountains of Israel. I myself will be the shepherd of my sheep, and I will make them lie down, says the Lord God. I will seek the lost, and I will bring back the strayed, and I will bind up the injured, and I will strengthen the weak. But the fat and the strong I will destroy. I will feed them with justice. Therefore, thus saith the Lord God to them, I myself will judge between the fat sheep and the lean sheep. Because you pushed with flank and shoulder and butted all the weak animals with your horns until you scatter them far and wide, I will save my flock, and they shall no longer be ravaged. And I will judge between sheep and sheep. I will set up over them one shepherd, my servant David, and he shall feed them. He shall feed them and be their shepherd. And I, the Lord, will be their God, and my servant David shall be prince among them. I, the Lord, have spoken. Here ends the first reading.
Strength of the from the letter to the Ephesians. I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love towards all the saints. And for this reason, I do not cease to give thanks for you as I remember you in my prayers. I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that, with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you, what are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe, according to the working of his great power. God put this power to work in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. And he has put all things under his feet, and has made him the head over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. This is the word of the Lord.
Lord be with you. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he'll put the sheep at his right hand and the goats at the left. And then the king will say to those at his right hand, 'Come, you that are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you gave me clothing. I was sick, and you took care of me. I was in prison, and you visited me.' Then the righteous will answer him, 'Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it that we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? And when was it that we saw you sick or in prison and visited you?' And the king will answer them, 'Truly, I tell you, just as you did it for one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it to me.' Then he will say to those at his left hand, 'You that are accursed, depart from me into eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger, and you did not welcome me. Naked, and you did not give me clothing. Sick and in prison, and you did not visit me. Then they also will answer, Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or sick or in prison and did not take care of you? Then he will answer them, truly I tell you, just as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me. And these will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous into eternal life. This is the gospel of the Lord.
May I speak in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. When I think of a king, I think of someone in charge. And this year I have longed for someone to be in charge, and for many more people to have exercised wise leadership in our world. Different governments have imposed different restrictions on their populations in this pandemic, and different cultures have responded differently to the rules set. Some have been more successful than others, but it isn't over yet. It has to be said that we don't like being told what to do. And as Christians especially, not be told we can't gather for public worship. We want, need to be free to worship, to live our lives, and be trusted to be responsible. When we find we're limited by some force or other, we develop often an us and them attitude. We can see it in the deep divisions in our world, the binary thinking which separates, divides, isolates. So today, on this feast of Christ the King, I want to consider not just us and them, or them and us, but them, God, and us, revealing that Christ brings about the freedom and life we long for as we follow his rule as King. I've talked about them. We are restricted by them. The political wrangles in the UK and the States reveal that our governments are flailing about trying to control the spread of the coronavirus and changing tack because people are dying and the NHS is overwhelmed. Who's got the answer? Which nation will lead the way in recovering our freedoms? Who is in charge? It's clearly not them. Nor us. So God? God is in charge, we hear in our gospel reading, and we will be judged, the sheep divided from the goats. Pope Pius XI in 1925 instituted the festival of Christ the King, because of the rising nationalism and emphasis on military might emerging in Europe. The feast of Christ the King stands as a reminder that Christ is King of Kings. He judges all the nations. One can hope that the sense of Christ as King might have sustained those who resisted fascism and those who fought in the Second World War. But we know, of course, it didn't prevent the kingdoms of this world, again, needing to solve their disputes by war. And so a century later, we need to be reminded again, God is sovereign of life and of death. While continuing to pray for our governments, we must look beyond them in faith to know that God is in control, in charge. And the image of Christ as King can bring us reassurance, but my hunch is that we struggle with Christ as judge. Although we make judgments and decisions all the time, we hate the thought of people weighing us up, talking about us. We can carry a sense that someone will pounce on us, reject us, or as we say, judge us. But a judgment isn't a sentence. We judge a piece of art, often to be beautiful. A judgment which identifies oppression and recommends mediation can transform people's lives. Judgment brings about justice. In Christ, it is always accompanied by mercy. Our readings are about sheep. Sheep get a raw deal in Christian minds, I think. We love to get children to glue cotton wool to pictures of the lost sheep, but we judge sheep to be dumb, blindly following the sheep in front. But sheep represent the livelihood of the shepherd. They are cared for, known as individuals, valuable. The image of Jesus as the Good Shepherd in the Gospel of John picks up on the reading we've had from the prophet Ezekiel, who promises a shepherd to lead the people, one who will feed the sheep, protect and care for the vulnerable, seek the lost and lead them. Them and us. Them, God, and us. The governments of the world are dealing with a pandemic they can't control. We resist them when we see the vulnerable not protected and justice compromised. We want someone to lead, sort it out, make it better, and so we blame them. That's them. God? God is in charge, in control, but in such a way that we cannot see all that is at play in the deeper purposes of God for each person or the future. We have to trust in God. Christ is sovereign, King of the nations, judge of all the world, because he is also shepherd of the sheep. Rather than focusing on things we cannot control, we might ponder how we might live if we believed that Christ is King, a King who looks after sheep like a good shepherd. And us? We are sheep, not dumb, stupid animals, but each of us of immense value to the shepherd. Today's parable of the separation of the sheep and goats isn't a parable which puts us in a passive role where things are done to us, restrictions imposed. In the parable of the sheep and the goats, nations are judged not on whether they are Christian or not. In fact, they may not have realized that it was Christ they were serving, it says. We are judged on how we treat people, anyone. For we serve Christ or don't, in any decision or judgment we make of another. So seek out opportunities to exhibit compassion. This year you may need to ring rather than visit. Send money directly because you won't be spending at a Christmas fair. Give to relieve the plight of refugees, those in prison, hungry and thirsty. For you serve Christ in all these acts. We approach Advent with Advent Sunday next week, where we will know Emmanuel, God with us as a baby. But today let us contemplate God with us as our King and Judge. God is Lord of all and Christ the Good Shepherd, our King and our Judge. We have a part to play in bringing about the kingdom. So let us act now, from hearts of compassion and pockets seeking to further justice. Amen.
Let us affirm our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father as the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through us. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray. Let us come into God's presence with thanksgiving, for the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods, and let us offer to him our prayers. Christ our King, ruler of the ends of the earth, all nations will gather and bow down before you. We pray that you will give to all governments and to all who rule a deep concern for the needs of their people. Grant them guidance and the gifts they need to govern wisely, that they may work for the good of all peoples, striving to promote justice, freedom of speech and opportunity, inner harmony and international peace. We pray that the nations of this world may be united and subject to the rule of Christ the King, through whom and for whom all things were created. We pray for earthly monarchs, and especially for Elizabeth, our Queen. May their rules be guided and influenced by the example set by your Son, who lives and reigns as King of Kings. Lord, in your mercy, God said, I will be the shepherd of my sheep. We pray for the church, that you would call us from the narrowness of our traditions to new ways of being church, so that we may call others to freedom, wholeness, and renewed faith. We pray especially for all those who cannot attend worship at this moment. Unite us through the love of Christ. We pray for David, our bishop, and Bishops Nicholas and Christopher. And we pray for the mission and ministry of this cathedral church, that it may be a guiding light and a place of peace to all who enter. In the wider church today, we're asked to pray for the Church of Bermuda and their Bishop, the Right Reverend Nicholas Dill. Lord, in your mercy, Christ our King, in you the thirsty find refreshment, the hungry are fed, the naked are clothed, and the prisoners are visited. Extend the boundaries of our concern beyond those who are easy to love. We bring before God those who are in despair, who have lost all hope in the future, those who are searching for peace in their lives, those burdened with anxiety, either about themselves or their loved ones. We pray for the communities of our friends and families, our church and our places of work and study, that you will be to them all that they most deeply need. We ask you to bless those whom we love and those very dear to us, and that you would protect them in these uncertain times. Help us to know the people around us to be our brothers and sisters in Christ, and so to serve them as he would serve them. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for all who are ill at this time, whether in hospital, long-term care, or at home, and those suffering from the effects of the pandemic. From our own congregation, we pray for Elizabeth Ann Phillips, Audrey Butterfield, Jennifer Lowther, Ivor and Gaynor George Jones, Alan Jones, Richard Bickmore, Peggy Catherine Harding, and Brendan Calvert, and those for whom we have been asked to pray: Nick Chambers, Sheila Blanchard, Jocelyn Russell, Michael Bowman, Clarissa Turner, Richard Annetts, Clara. And in a moment of silence, we pray for anyone known to us who needs our prayers today. Lord, in your mercy, Christ our King, you have conquered death and tell us to look forward to the day when your kingdom will come and your will be done, when there will be no more suffering, sorrow, or death, a place where there will be no more mourning and weeping, and every tear will be wiped from our eyes. We pray for those we love but see no longer. And we bring before God all those who have died this week, especially those whose death is untimely, those who have died through accident, violence, or disasters. Be with all who mourn. Grant them your special blessing, that they may discover the comfort you have promised and find strength to face tomorrow. We pray for those who've died recently: John Widow's Priest, Matt Ward, Barbara Wilson, Margaret Green, John Nurser Priest, and their family and friends. Lord, in your mercy. Faithful God, we give thanks to you for all that you do in our lives. And as the church year comes to an end, we commend to you all those for whom we have prayed throughout the year, and ask that you continue to use us and our prayers to make a difference in the world. Rejoicing in the fellowship of Mary the Virgin, Hugh of Lincoln, and all the saints, we commend ourselves and the whole creation to your unfailing love. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
God calls us to peace. In God's justice is our peace. Christ calls us to be God's people. In Christ is our peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Blessed be God who enthrones us with Christ in the heavenly realms. May we feed upon the bread of God and drink the royal wine of heaven.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. For with the oil of gladness you have anointed Christ the Lord, your only Son, to be our great High Priest and King of all creation. As priest, he offered himself once for all upon the altar of the cross and redeemed the human race by this perfect sacrifice of peace. As king, he claims dominion over all your creatures, that he may bring before your infinite majesty a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so with angels and archangels and all the heavenly host, we proclaim your glory and join in their unending hymn of praise.
Oh.
grace and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again, he praised you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross, bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation. We proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with Mary the Virgin, Hugh of Lincoln, and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. Amen. Let us pray for the coming of God's kingdom in the words our Saviour taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many,
we are one body,
because we all share. God's holy gifts for God's holy people. Jesus Christ is holy. Jesus Christ is Lord. To the glory of God the Father. I invite you to make your spiritual communion, praying that by God's grace, united with all the baptized and with Christ who gave his life for us, you may be filled with his indwelling presence.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Stir up, O Lord, the wills of your faithful people, that they plenteously bringing forth the fruit of good works may by you be plenteously rewarded. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Merciful God, you have called us to your table and nourished us with the bread of life. Draw us and all people to serve your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Go into the world to walk in God's light, to rejoice in God's love, and to reflect God's glory. God the Father, who has given to his Son the name above every name, strengthen you to proclaim Christ as Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.